This waterfall, flowing down the Virgin River, surrounded by trees and sandstone cliffs, isn't actually a waterfall. It's fake. It's actually a dam. A huge slab of concrete covered in rock built to protect an aging water pipe. And for 70 years, it's presented a problem. A dam problem for Zion National Park's native fish. They can't get upstream. So the park, alongside the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service Fish Passage Program, and a lot of heavy machinery, got rid of it to improve the habitat and the infrastructure.
So the purpose of this project is to improve natural fish movement throughout the Virgin River system here in Zion National Park, while providing for, where possible, more resilient water infrastructure.
There are four native fish species that live in the Virgin River in Zion National Park. Two species of suckers, desert suckers and flannelmouth suckers, and two minnows, the Virgin's fine dace and speckled dace.
The four native fish species rely on being able to freely move up and down the river for spawning and also for utilizing different kinds of habitats.
Having that space to swim freely lends itself to genetic diversity, which creates a healthy population. The park's native fish species can't cross the man-made dam and are stuck downstream. That's habitat needed for these fish to thrive. And these kinds of fish are the most at risk.
Within the U.S., the native fish species within our freshwater systems are the most imperiled species that we have. These type of projects, what we're doing is we're ensuring resiliencies for these very fragile species in these systems that are actively being degraded.
And fish are an integral part of the park's ecosystem as a whole.
It's all a very complex but delicately balanced system. And we want to do our best to restore that and keep it as healthy as we possibly can.
There are multiple dams needing removal in Zion, and they all present the same issues.
We've got four barriers in this system. They prevent migration for fish, they fragment our rivers, they cause issues in sedimentation.
We started at the top. This is the site of the first dam demolition, the Temple of Sinawava.
Where we have the uppermost dam that restricts movement into 100 river miles of habitat.
Getting rid of the dam took calculated destruction and careful action to remove the fish from the area. Biologists from Zion National Park and the Utah Division of Wildlife Resources came in prior to the dam removal to record the fish in the area and place them downstream away from the construction.
We removed over 100 fish through this process. It's about 300 linear feet of the waterway that was completely dewatered.
Using heavy equipment in the river would cause more harm than good to the fish. So construction crews diverted the river into a new channel using sandbags and recycled native material to create a temporary dam.
They also dug out
a large channel for the river to flow. Then came the jackhammering, scooping, and concrete busting.
There were over 300 cubic yards of concrete material that were removed from the North Fork of the Virgin River, as well as the old water line and rebar that was used to reinforce the concrete.
Once all of the concrete was removed and a new water line was placed below the river bottom, the river was diverted back to its original channel. Afterwards, once all the construction crews cleared, the park's revegetation crew and volunteers came in to revegetate the area, to boost the habitat, to make it healthy again. Now, we have a new view of the river. Not a fake concrete waterfall, but this. A river fit for the fish that live in it.
Our fish can pass, they can migrate, reach additional habitat. And so anytime we can put it back to a more nature-like situation where things are functioning properly, we're always so excited to do that.
The new design for the Fish Passage Project simulates water flow, depth, and velocity to find the best conditions for the fish to swim without being blocked or swept away, which includes weirs, think of them as tiny ramps, to help the fish get upstream. Engineers and biologists use these models to create safe passage routes, ensuring fish migration isn't disrupted and aquatic ecosystems stay healthy. But the work doesn't end here.
There's some big findings in there.
Biologists are monitoring the fish to see how successful the project is in the long term and what they can learn from it going forward. They can do this through these tiny fish-sized tags and antennas lining the river that track them.
What we've developed is a monitoring system that operates all day long, every day of the year, no matter what time of day it is or what the river's flowing at.
All of this takes many experts and passionate staff to make it possible.
Conservation actions cannot occur without collaboration. The Park Service is not doing this alone.
It took many agencies to complete this project, and success flows far beyond the waters of this site, removing barriers that fragment rivers, block fish migration, and put communities at higher flood risk. Is one of the most effective ways to help conserve vulnerable species while building safer and more resilient infrastructure for people. And you can help your own communities to help your native fisheries.
We're doing our best here, but we hope that this inspires you to think about what you can do better at home.